Namaskar children, we had discussed acceleration in the last class. Today we are going to discuss that acceleration can be uniform as well as non-uniform. So uniform acceleration is when velocity of an object increases by equal amounts in equal intervals of time. For example, here, suppose the object is starting from zero velocity and the velocity is increasing by 3 meter per second after every 1 second. So the velocity is changing by equal amounts. Every time it is changing by 3 meter per second after every 1 second. So in such a case, the acceleration is uniform and it is 3 meters per second square. Whereas in non-uniform acceleration, the velocity of the object increases by unequal amounts in equal intervals of time. So suppose this time, after every 1 second, the velocity is changing but at non-uniform rate. Suppose the object started with 0, then after 1 second the velocity is 1 meter per second, after another 1 second the velocity increases to 3.5 meter per second, and after the next 1 second it jumps to 10 meter per second. So the change in velocity or the increase in velocity is not constant. So this is non-uniform acceleration. So students, we have discussed acceleration and also that acceleration can be either uniform or non-uniform. We had done a few numericals also on acceleration in the previous session, where in the formula acceleration is change in velocity upon time, you had to simply put the values for initial and final velocity and the time taken for the change to happen. Every time for calculations, data given will not be in this simple form. There may be cases where the data given is of large quantity. Comprehending and interpreting data when it is given in large quantity becomes difficult. To ease out that process, we take the help of graphs. That is what we are going to discuss next, how motion can be described and represented with the help of graphs. So, the next topic of discussion would be graphical representation of motion. In this, we will be discussing two types of graphs, distance time graphs and velocity time graphs. Both these types of graphs will help us to understand and represent motion of objects around us better. Graphical representation of motion. As mentioned, we are going to discuss distance time graphs and velocity time graphs. To start with, distance time graphs, which you have already been introduced in class 7th also. This is how we mark the axis. We use the x-axis for marking the time intervals and we use the y-axis for marking the distance. Let the first situation be that when we start observing the object, that means at t0, suppose the object was at a fixed position, say 4 meters from this point of observation. Let distance be here in meters and t here be in seconds. So at the starting point, the object was at 4 meters from the point of observation. Say after an interval of 5 seconds, when we observed the object, it was still at 4 meters. So these are the two points that we have plotted till now. After the next 5 seconds, say the object is still at the same position, at 4 meters from the point of observation. And after the next 5 seconds also, the object is still at the same position. So if we join all these points, we get a line parallel to the time axis. This situation is representing that the object is at rest. The position of the object or the distance of the object is not changing with time. So we call that the object is at rest. So this is how the DT graph of an object at rest looks like. A line parallel to the time axis. Let us now consider another situation. Suppose this time also we are observing the object after every 5 seconds. When we started observing the object, that is at t0, suppose the object was at the initial point, that is origin only. So the first coordinate is the origin itself. After the next 5 seconds, suppose the object reaches the 10 meter mark. It reaches 10 meters from the observation point, the starting point. After the next 5 seconds, suppose the object reaches 20 meter mark. It covers another 10 meters. And after the next 5 seconds, suppose the object reaches 30 meter mark. So, at T0, the object was at the initial point, that is 0. After 5 seconds, it has covered 10 meters. After the next 5 seconds, it has again covered 10 meters and reaches 20. And after the next 5 seconds, it has covered 10 meters further and it reaches 30 meter mark. So now if we join all these points, it comes out to be a straight line which is at a constant inclination with the time axis. This angle is fixed, this inclination is fixed, and it is a straight line. This type of graph represents that object is covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. Could you recall? Yes, this is uniform motion. The object is in uniform motion, or in other words, you can say that the object is traveling at constant speed. The object is covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. Like in this case, we have taken an example that in every 5 seconds, the object is covering 10 meters. So this is representing uniform motion, straight line going up, constant angle with the time axis. Let us now consider another situation. Suppose this time also we are observing the object at the intervals of 5 seconds. And initially, suppose the object is at the origin only. Let after the first 5 seconds, the object has reached the 2 meter mark. So, the object has reached 2 meters after the first 5 seconds. Say after the next 5 seconds, suppose the object has reached the 8 meter mark. So, the object has covered 6 meters more. Earlier it was at 2, now it is at 8. So it has covered these 6 meters in the next 5 seconds. And suppose in the another 5 seconds, it covers 2 more meters and reaches the 10 meter mark. So initially it was at origin. After 5 seconds, it reaches 2 meters. In the next 5 seconds, it reaches the 8 meter mark. And in the next 5 seconds, it reaches the 10 meter mark. So if I join all these points freehand, what do I get is a curve. This type of graph is representing non-uniform motion, or we can say that the object is moving with a variable speed. So these are the three types of distance time graphs that we have discussed. Object at rest, where the DT graph will be a straight line parallel to the time axis, which shows distance is not changing with time, so the object is at rest. Uniform motion or uniform speed, that means distance is changing with time at a constant pace, so the speed is constant, or we call it uniform motion. And non-uniform motion or non-uniform speed, where distance is changing with time at a non-uniform rate. We can use distance time graph to calculate the speed of the object as well. For example, we have a distance time graph given here, where the object has been observed after every 5 seconds, and the distance
it covers has been plotted. So initially the object is at 0, after 5 seconds it covers 20 meters, after the next 5 seconds it has covered another 20 meters, next 5 seconds another 20 meters, and in the last 5 seconds also it has covered 20 meters. So in total the object has traveled for 20 seconds and it has covered 80 meters. Now from this graph, if we have to calculate the speed of the object, we have to calculate the slope of the graph. What do we mean by slope of the graph is, it is calculated as the change in y coordinate divided by change in the x coordinate.
Calculating speed from dt graph. For calculating speed from dt graph, we'll have to calculate the slope of the graph. And slope of the graph is defined as the change in the y coordinate divided by change in x coordinate. What do we mean by this? We'll take the help of this graph to understand. Suppose this is a dt graph given here for uniform motion. As you already know, how does a uniform motion graph look like? So to calculate the slope of the graph, we have to select any two points on this graph. So let me select the two points on this graph. Let it be this point and this point. So suppose these are the two points selected on the graph for calculating the slope, and using this length, let it be length AB, using this length AB as the hypotenuse, I'll complete a right triangle like this. So these are the two points that I have selected. I have made this side as the hypotenuse and I have completed the right triangle. Let this point be labeled as C. So change in y coordinate here would be this length BC, and change in x coordinate here would be this length AC. What we are trying to do here is, we are trying to find out that when x coordinate is changing by this much amount, how much is the y coordinate changing? So if I look carefully at the graph, the change in the y coordinate is from 20 to 80, that is this length BC. So change in the y coordinate, which is length BC, and change in the x coordinate, which is length AC. Length BC here can be clearly calculated looking at the y-axis. Length BC is 80 minus 20, and length AC here is 20 minus 5, this length. So when we calculate, we get the slope of the graph as 60 divided by 15, which when we solve further comes out to be 4. Now on the y-axis we have plotted distance, and on the x-axis we have plotted time. So here change in y coordinate upon change in x coordinate is giving some distance divided by time, and distance upon time is defined as speed. So this quantity that we have calculated as the slope of dt graph is speed. To strengthen the concept, we'll do a few more numericals on the same. So suppose this is a graph given to you and you have to calculate speed from this graph. Again, as we can see, it's a graph representing uniform motion
straight line with constant inclination to the x-axis, time axis, and you have to find the speed of the object. So we'll calculate the slope of the graph. So as we just discussed, how do we calculate the slope of the graph? We select any two points on the graph. So let those two points be these ones, and using these two points A and B as the hypotenuse, we'll complete the right triangle. So this is the right triangle ABC. Now slope has been defined as change in y divided by change in x. So length BC divided by length AC. So when we put the values for change in the y coordinate, how much is the y coordinate changing? If you can see clearly, it is from 20 to 40. So what is the change? 20 to 40. That is the change in the y coordinate. So 40 minus 20 divided by change in the x coordinate. How much is the x coordinate changing during this time? You can see clearly on the x-axis from 4 to 6, 4 to 8. So length AC would be 8 minus 4. That is the change in the x-axis, time axis. So when we solve it further, we get 20 by 4, which is coming out to be 5 meter per second. I hope the calculation of slope or speed from a DT graph is clear. We take any two points on the graph, we label them as AB and consider AB as the hypotenuse and complete a right triangle. Then we divide the height of this triangle divided by the base. So height is the change in the y coordinate, which is in this case 20 meters, and base here is the change in the x coordinate, here 4 seconds. So slope is 20 by 4, that is 5 meter per second, or we can say the speed of the object is 5 meter per second. Now remember children, whatever are the two points that you select, it could have been the zero point and the last point, or these two points, or the first and the third mark here. Any two points on this line, this graph, would have given you the same answer, because it's a graph which is representing uniform motion. Slope in such graphs is constant. It is fixed. I repeat, if you select any other two points other than the ones that we have selected, you would have got the same answer, because it's a straight line graph, it's a uniform motion graph, the slope is fixed, and hence the speed.